Michelle Glass here, and our job for today is to look at the muscles of the head and neck. And not only are we going to pick out the important muscles here, but we will also be picking out three of our cervical plexus nerves that are part of our spinal nerve. So we'll be doing that today as well. To begin, let's look at the muscle called the epicranium, which is going to be above or upon the cranial bones. That includes the occipital belly or occipitalis, the flat epicranial aponeurosis, so the flat tendon connecting occipitalis to the frontalis or frontal belly. From there, pick out your orbicularis oculi. Notice that's orbiting or going around the eye orbit as well as the eyelids. Then you can find your zygomaticus minor, zygomaticus major, buccinator, risorius. Then pick out your orbicularis oris. So it's another circular muscle going around the opening of the mouth. Next, right here, pick out your levator labii superioris. The bottom lip, you have the depressor labii inferioris. At the corner of the mouth, you have the depressor anguli oris. Then we can see the mentalis muscles here, right where the mental foramen is located. Remember, mental means chin. Going across the nose, you have the nasalis, and then kind of longitudinally, you have the procerus. On the dissected side, this deep muscle is called the temporalis, and here we have the masseter. Now remember, the masseter is going to elevate the mandible, and notice it's attached to the mandible and the zygomatic bone. Because we are contracting toward the origin, and the mandible is the bone that's moving, the mandible is the insertion, the zygomatic bone is the origin. Next, so let's look kind of under the chin. We have both bellies of the digastric here and back here. And then we have both bellies here and here of the omohyoid. Next, we can see this large muscle, which is the sternocleidomastoid. Sternocleidomastoid is named for the origin and the insertion. So the origin is actually the sternum and the clavicle. The insertion, I don't know if I said that right, the origin, I did. Origin is the sternum and the clavicle. The insertion is the mastoid process. If you're contracting both sternocleidomastoid muscles together, that's going to flex the neck. If you're doing just one side, that's lateral flexion. Sitting on top of the sternocleidomastoid, you can see the greater auricular nerve. You can also see a small little piece of the transverse cervicalis here. Our other nerve that we're naming is called the phrenic nerve, which you can see on the side where the sternocleidomastoid muscle has been dissected. The phrenic nerve is spelled with a PH, and that stands for or refers to the diaphragm. Okay, going to this view here, you can see the trapezius. It's just a very small piece of this. We can see this in all of its glory on a later model. We can see here, and here, splenius capitis, here, and here, levator scapulae. Right here we can see the rhomboid minor. The rhomboid major is lower down, and we don't have that visible in any of our models. So this is rhomboid minor. And then when we're looking at this cut view here, you can see on either side of the vertebrae, the erector spinae group of muscles. And that should be it for this model.